Welcome back. Before we get into the meat and potatoes of Azure SQL, we thought it'd be nice to start with an introduction with a history of how Azure SQL came to be. And throughout the rest of the module, we'll cover overview of the various deployment options and then some comparison between those, especially how it relates to the different service tiers and purchasing models. Now, as we start to think about the history of Azure SQL, you know, Bob, you've been around a while. Can you tell us a little bit about, you know, the history of Azure SQL as you've seen it?
Very kind of you to use the word a while, Anna, given your age and how long I've been at Microsoft. But no, I remember being an employee back in 2008. You see in this photo right here, Ray Ozzie had joined Microsoft as a chief technology architect for the company. And Ray brought with him this amazing idea of taking our enterprise products, such as like Windows and SQL, and turning them into cloud services that people would consume. And you see a photo right here of Ray at what's called the Professional Developers Conference in 2008, announcing Windows Azure, and SQL was part of that. Professional Developers Conference is the predecessor to Build Conference today. Now, this is an amazing thing for Microsoft back in the mid-2000s, as we were getting credibility in the enterprise space, to come out and think that cloud services could be these kind of technologies versus something just like Bing Search or Hotmail. So let's take a little deeper dive into the history of Azure SQL itself. It's really come a long ways. In fact, even before that announcement, Windows Azure and SQL Azure had these cloud project names, CloudDB for Azure SQL and Red Dog for Windows Azure. And if you look at this evolution along the way up till today's timeframe, you can see it wasn't just always about the technology. Sometimes it was a branding change. So for example, in 2012, we took SQL Azure as a brand and called it Azure SQL Database, which you see today, Azure SQL Database, you'll find out in our series, as part of the Azure SQL suite. But there were other major product announcements and changes that significantly altered the landscape. Like Azure Virtual Machines in 2013 was a very big milestone, because before you didn't have the ability to do a complete VM. And we'll actually briefly talk about that some here in the first module in a later video. But I look at 2015 as a huge landmark for us. We launched something called V12, and that was a version of Azure SQL, which underneath the covers changed the architecture to provide a lot more resiliency and performance for our customers in the cloud. And then you see here the evolution continues. And in 16, we want to do things called elastic pools, which we're going to mention in our videos. And then finally, you're going to hear today, because Anna's already kind of mentioned to you about some of the things we're going to cover in the entire series, Azure SQL Managed Instance, project name CloudLifter, because some of our customers were struggling to lift their applications and databases in the cloud because of the surface area of Azure Database wasn't enough. And so we provide like an instance of SQL Server called Managed Instance, which you'll see throughout our series and our entire training that we're providing you. And then finally, you look at last year was a major, major milestone for Azure SQL. Things like hyperscale, which we're going to talk about to give you new amazing performance capabilities. Serverless, really cool technology for auto-scaling and for great cost optimizing cost scenarios. And then instance pools, which is another factor of doing Azure Managed Instance. So, you know, if I look back from the very beginning in 2006 all the way to today, We've changed the landscape of the evolution of how we've presented SQL in the cloud, but also the branding to reflect all the different options we're giving our customers. So you can see Azure SQL has this amazing legacy and history. And what we're going to show you in the rest of this series is the great technology built on that foundation from so long ago. And we continue to iterate on Azure SQL, and you're going to see the fruits of that through the entire series of all the options we provide you and how Azure SQL really is your SQL server in the cloud. We hope to see you in the next video.